I was browsing through many old radio and electronics magazines from the 1970s and the 1960s, and I found this very interesting circuit. Of course, in those days many circuits were made with germanium transistors, so I had to do some adaptations, choose other transistors, do some minor, say, changes in the circuit. And all these, say, simple signal generators also work with both with germanium and silicon transistors. So that's no problem in general. Germanium transistors are very sensitive to temperature changes. They can oscillate much easier. There is a risk of thermal runaway. Anyway, this is the circuit that I made on the basis of an old circuit in a radio magazine. And it's a metronome circuit. Very easy to make. I had not expected that it immediately worked. Anyway, this is what it is. And here you see the schematic more in detail. Here we set the frequency, aligning, say, the metronome frequency to a certain musical tact, etc. And this capacitor sets the frequency where it works and where, say, how many pulses the circuit gives during 1 second or half a second or so. Very, very easy to make. The speaker is here, this simple speaker, but I'm absolutely sure when you use a bigger speaker and mount it in a box, you have a more full, rich sound. And that's perhaps better. Now it sounds like something is clicking. Anyway, it's what you want and what you like and what you need. When you mount a LED parallel to the loudspeaker, that LED has an effect on the sound. So the sharpness of the sound changes, and that's why I've used here a resistor of 150 ohms. You can go to 470 ohms, of course. That depends, of course, on the LED, and I've used a bright red LED. The transistors that I used, the BC547, NPN silicon, amplification factor approximately 250, and a BC556B, it's a PNP transistor. It's here. And has also a high amplification factor. I have to switch on the battery, 9 volt battery. And the circuit is working now. And we can see it on the scope. Good waveform, by the way. Very sharp peak. That's not bad. And again, with a real loudspeaker box, you will have a pure, full sound with more bass frequencies. And here's that LED. It flickers on the frequency. And the frequency is set by these two capacitors. I've now soldered in three electrolytics in parallel. All the three are 50 microfarads. So we now have here 150 microfarad. And let's change the frequency somewhat. See what happens. And listen. So this is very, very slow, but could be it is necessary in a kind of musical performance. We now go to higher frequencies. So, some joy with this circuit, and somewhat higher. Well, this is very, very, very quick. Of course, this is a kind of elementary circuit. We all know that, for instance, electrolytic capacitors are temperature sensitive. Of course, when the battery depletes, it will perhaps be somewhat more difficult. I don't have enough time to test that. Somewhat more difficult to keep the right frequency, the right metronome frequency, that's what I mean. But anyway, it's, in my opinion, a very interesting circuit. And perhaps when you change the capacitors here to 100 nanofarad or so, I have not tested that, I'm not going to test that. You have perhaps a good quality sound generator. And the frequency depends on this value of the capacitor and the value of the resistor.